Welcome to Fukushima Update. Our feature this week focuses on the election of next governor of Tokyo and the return of nuclear power to the forefront of political debate. But first, we begin with some news about Tokyo Electric Power Company. Officials have just unveiled a new plan to make their company profitable again. One of the premises of TEPCO's restructuring plan is to restart two reactors at the Kashiwazaki Kariwa nuclear plant by July of this year. With all of its reactors currently idle, the company is importing huge amounts of fossil fuels to fire up thermal plants. The cost of these imports is weighing heavily on its budget.
7月再稼働の、見通しということですけれども、まさに仮置きですので、まだ今、安全審査をお願いしている段階で、それをまたこれからもずっと続くわけですので、再稼働計画ではございません。
The company says failure to restart nuclear reactors would force it to again increase electricity rates around fall of this year. The government has approved the restructuring plan.The president of TEPCO traveled to Niigata Prefecture to brief local authorities on his plan, but the response was far from positive. President Hirose met with the governor of Niigata, who voiced strong criticism against the plan.
特に柏崎刈羽原発、全く協議ないままですね、申請をされたということで大変残念に思っています。計画の作り方自身に問題がある。私はそういうふうに受け止めてますので。
The governor says he will not allow TEPCO to restart nuclear reactors without further analysis and a better understanding of the Fukushima accident. Time now for our weekly feature. The race to elect a new governor in Tokyo saw the arrival last week of a surprise candidate.He's opposed to nuclear power and has been endorsed by a famous politician. Now Japan's leaders fear this local election might turn into a referendum on energy policy.
A major money scandal prompted Tokyo Governor Naoki Inose to resign in December, just 1 year after being elected. Candidates to his succession emerged gradually after an election date was set for February 9th.Last week, a highly anticipated meeting between two political heavyweights took place in a hotel in central Tokyo. Reporters surrounded the arrival of former Prime Minister Junichiro Koizumi. He came back on the national stage last year by announcing his opposition to nuclear power. Koizumi was on his way to meet with Morihiro Hosokawa,another former prime minister and a potential contender in the race for Tokyo governor.
いろいろ国の抱えている問題全般について、忌憚のないお話をいたしました。いろいろ示唆に富んだお話をいただいて、私も今度の都知事選に、立候補するという、決断をいたしました。
決断された最大の理由はどちらでしょうか?
それは今の日本のさまざまな問題、特に原発の問題などについてですね、非常に私なりに国の存亡に関わる問題だという危機感を持っているからです。
The announcement sent shockwaves across the political world. Hosokawa's stance put nuclear power back at the center of national politics.And his endorsement came from a highly popular figure who once ruled the Liberal Democratic Party.
私も喜んで積極的に細川さん当選のために頑張るということをお伝えしました。私は原発ゼロで日本は発展できるという考えに立ってますから、それは細川さんも同じだと思いますよ。それが私の細川さんを応援する最大の理由です。東京が原発なしでやっていけるという姿を見せれば、必ず国を変えることができる。
Koizumi stated clearly his ambition to influence the course of politics beyond the Japanese capital.
今回の都知事選挙ほど国政に影響を与える選挙はないでしょうね。特に細川さんが知事に 当選すればエネルギー問題、原発問題、これは国政を揺るがす大きな影響力を与える知事になると思いますね。
Morihiro Hosokawa is 76 years old. He became prime minister in 1993 after a historic win over the Liberal Democratic Party, which had dominated national politics for nearly 40 years. A money scandal forced him to resign after just 8 months. He retired from politics and turned his attention to ceramics. Hosokawa says the debate over nuclear power is the main factor behind his political comeback. Hosokawa's anti-nuclear platform is a big thorn in the side of Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, whose administration hopes to restart idled reactors once they clear safety inspections. Abe's party doesn't want the election to turn into a referendum on nuclear power.
東京都が直面する諸課題についてもですね、バランスよく議論をされ、そして都民の皆さんにとって充実した選挙戦になることを期待したいと思います。
The ruling coalition is supporting Yoichi Masuzoe, a former health minister. His campaign focuses on other pressing issues, including social security and the Tokyo Olympics.
まず第一にですけれども、2020年の五輪、オリンピック・パラリンピック、これを何としても成功させたい。
The Hosokawa Koizumi coalition means voters in Tokyo will have to take nuclear power into account when they head to the polls. Whoever wins the election will yield considerable influence. The capital is Japan's largest consumer of electricity. It also owns a major stake in Tokyo Electric Power Company. The stage is set for a major showdown on February 9th. Miguel Quintana, NTV, Tokyo.
The Japanese government has postponed the announcement of its new energy policy until after the election. The document states that nuclear power is an essential source of electricity and paves the way for the restart of nuclear plants. Eight other candidates have declared their intention to run for governor of Tokyo. Hosokawa and Masuzoe are seen as the main contenders. And that's it for this edition of Fukushima Update. Please send us your comments to the address below. Thank you for watching and see you again next week.